Hello everyone, welcome back to the walkthrough. As soon as that big fish stairs showed up, I decided, I'm gonna go ahead for that one because it's closer, even though I was going for that other one at the upper left corner there. But that turned out to be a very good decision because guess what I got in this catch, finally. If you guessed it was the Stowfish, you would be right. And oh, jeez, did it take me a while to get this. I mean, granted it was off and on work, but it was so boring and it took me so many attempts. And it's just so many fish to catch. You don't know which one's gonna be the fish that has the Stowfish attached to it. I should say a fish that has a Stowfish attached to it. So you basically had to catch everything that you've seen unless it was a Skippy Jack. And yeah, it was just... but I got it. For 100% fish completion. Those are some wide circles you're doing there, post-PkGam. I should say, pre-PkGam. And there you go. And this is the little cutscene that you get once you get a fish. Unless you had, has a Stowfish. See, it zooms in on the spot. Look how cute that thing is! Woo! And I got it! And I am done with it. So I'm gonna go head back over to Banan Island now, if you don't mind. Back to live commentary! So, Banan Island, I think you know what we need to do with this fish now that we have it, finally. How's it going? What hard rations? Many thanks. And what do you need? I definitely am, and this fish is the greatest, happiest fish of all. No, that's not true. Look a little closer and you'll see it. I will, but just, come on, just take a little peek at this one that I've got here. Yeah, yep, yeah, see it? Yeah, you got it! A little fish of pure adventure symbolizes the wayfarer's lifestyle. You're naive, yes, but you know what it is to follow your hearts. I think this little discovery deserves a small gift. And we get another random ship part. But of course, the Stowfish is in itself its own reward for the whole 100% completion dealio thing. Alright, look at that, look at that. Now, I assure you I've tried getting... I've caught more fish than this, it's just that I didn't save them all. It's just so when I got frustrated, I'd be like, I'm done. I just exile the whole emulator window and I lose whatever fish that I caught. So I probably caught over 100 fish trying to get this one Stowfish. But yes, and you can get as many Stowfish as you want, providing you have the tolerance for it, and they'll just keep track of that. And over here you can see the size of the largest fish that you were able to catch. Alright, so the fish are 100%ed, but there are other things that need 100%ing. Specifically, I think you know about those little red X's. Yes, 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 little red X's. Do you remember the little red X's? Well, I remember the little red X's. They were on that portion of the map, I do believe. Northeast, right? Wasn't it? Yes, okay. I was wondering if I got the symbol right, because it's been a while since I've played, but that is okay. Alright, get your salvage arm ready, and... dive. I should say dip. And go. Go, 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 go. The cursor is slightly off the screen, but that is okay. You can tell where I am based on where that... I was gonna say lever, but it's like a lever-slider combo. See, the red dot, I mean the red circle there is indicative of a lever. And it's sliding along a track of sorts. Oh, no, current. No, current. Yes. Treasure chests! Alright, here we go. This will be the 30th one. We can do it. We can do it. Believe in yourself. Believe it. I know you're coming, so I'm weaving off to the side. Yes. Memorize your route. when you go down, so it's easier when you come back up. And there you go. Alright, what do we get? What do we get? Probably nothing important, because we 100%ed everything besides these X's. Well, that's pretty impressive. I mean, we don't need any more rupees, but yeah, it's a big gold rupee. There we go. Let's flip-flop around into what is probably shark-infested territory. Which I think there are actually sharks that spawn around this particular area. Fly free, golden frog! Well, swim free. I'm never gonna need to shoot you again. Yes. Have a good time in the wild blue sea. Alright, I gotta keep my eyes out for enemies. I mean, I've got 7 health here, but it doesn't mean that I'm invincible. But what I do need, though, is that one last X for 100% completion. And I'm done with the fish, dang it. Oh, it's still counting from... it's still crediting my rupees. It was still, you know, it was going up that whole time. Alright, I think this is close enough. Number 31. Prepare your body. For the finale of the 100%ing. Here we go. We can do it. But can we do it without taking a hit? That is the question. Probably not, because I'm pretty clumsy on this. We'll see. We'll see. I don't care about your waviness. There's nothing nearby me. And careful. There we go. No missing. And now we go up. And hopefully this will be the last one. Because I don't want to take 5 damage here. I mean, yeah, I said I don't want to do it without taking a hit at all, but really, I would just be happy getting through without losing my load here. Thank you very much. Especially with how long it's been. I should say how long it took me to get the Stowfish from off and on playing and whatnot. So, yeah, this part is a long time coming. Alright, let's see our final prize from the X's. We get... Sickle Anchor Shipper! It's randomized! I always thought that the randomization of the, of the ship part thing was just kind of baloney, because it's like, the first ship part that you could get any of the ship parts. And the last part that you get could be any of the ship parts, so it's like, what's the point, really? I mean, yeah, it is to upgrade your ship, but it's not like you can easily keep getting ship parts during the course of the game that'll make, you know, a significant difference for most runs. So it's just more of like a collector's trade sake, I guess, to bring in link functionality and whatnot, I would say, more than anything. Because I just don't feel crazy enough to go for those ship parts. Anyway, I'm back over here on Cannon Island because I was told about a wee little tree that contains a good old prize. So I'm just going to take a look-see around the place, and I actually scouted out ahead of time. And it is on this side of the island. I think this would be the fastest way around, not taking the other way around, because then I have to go through the cave and whatnot. Alright, so I go down, I think this is the tree right here, so I'm going to try and roll into it, get out of my way, you're just going to make me nervous. Yep, I'm not good with the circles on the edge of the screen. I'm glad that they change us for later Zelda's, oh shoot, not the menu. Come on, circles! It's probably because I'm just on such a small screen that it makes such a hassle doing the rolls on this one. Because I don't remember ever having this much issue on the actual console. Well, handheld, I should say. Come on, come on! There we go! I knew it was here! Yes! Because I did the scouting. So yes, a whopping 200 rupee prize from that tree, and we can now get out of here. As a matter of fact, much easier going back than it is going up there. But anyhow, Yeah, let's set sail. Now I'm gonna go over to the Temple of the Ocean King. You're probably wondering why I want to come back here again when I say we're done with the place. Well, there's like a post-game dealio here going on in that there is, you know, perhaps maybe might be a thingy up over here. What is this here? Let's just take a peek-see and plop in here. Look at that! Look at that! Yeah, this is over way, way back on the... Yeah, this is on the very last floor here. And that's why you can't really go back to, yeah, the final boss type place here and whatnot. So, well, I should say after you beat the final boss's first phase, this is over here. And you can still read this tablet and stuff like that, but still, you can't go up the stairs or anything like that. And there's also another thing that I'd like to show you over here. Is that if you were to go... Wait, actually, maybe I don't have to go all the way through the whole temple again, because that is where it was blocked off. Because I was going to say, I think that the last door on the last floor is blocked off. But yeah, maybe I don't have to do that, because that might have been the thing that I was thinking of. But yeah, if you go all the way to the last floor, I do believe that that is the thing that you would find locked off. But anyway, post-game... there's a certain thingajigger here now that it's sort of like a time trial, in that you can see how fast you can get through the temple and whatnot. But I don't really feel like doing that. I've been through the temple enough. So yeah, I think I'm done here with the Temple of the Ocean King, because I showed you the door that I wanted to show you over there. At least that's the door that I think is the thing that gets shut. Because you notice that that bridge always pops up. Well, I believe if you get to the last floor, you know, with the bunch of phantoms you gotta kill to get through the door. And then, you know, you go through the door thusly, and then you cross the bridge. Well, when you cross the bridge falls out, and you're stuck at that, because that's the furthest you can get into the temple, and then there's your high score. Well, if you manage to reach the end of that, but I should say you manage to reach the end of it and on your best time. It is possible to do the Temple of the Ocean King and get to the end of it with a full 25 minutes on the clock. It's tricky, though. I don't really feel like going through the temple again, but I'm just saying, if you want to give it a shot, you can do so and try and get your 25-minute world record. As for me, I am now going to go back over to the ghost ship. Like, you might have noticed that the ghost ship was fluttering along the Great Sea over by, well, you know, these sets of islands over here. Yeah, well, believe it or not, this takes place, like, just before the final battle with Bellumbeck. So that's how, you know, all these events are still going on, you know, as you can keep continuing to 100% the game and whatnot. So see, you gotta go to that ghost ship for Tetra, and yeah, yeah. She's still technically not rescued on the save file, even though the save file is beaten and the time trial mode for the Temple of the Ocean King is unlocked and whatnot. But yeah, if you go back over to the ghost ship, you can actually replay the battle of Bellumbeck, if you'd like, and yeah, that's a pretty nice little thingy-jigger. but the thing that I'm going for back over there is not necessarily just to replay the final battle for the sake of replaying the final battle, but to show you a little something, is that I was told that the boss does the spin attack when you're far enough away from it, and I wasn't far enough away from it in the fight, and that's why, you know, implying that I wasn't far enough away from it in the fight, and which is why it didn't do it. So I'm just going to restart that final battle there and see what we can do about that. Like, maybe I'll be able to show that spin attack. Hopefully. All I do know is that the poor ghost ship is just kind of half sunk over here. Alright, let's do a little skipper here. Now we just press the start button on the controller to get that up. Start button. Yeah. I know. Skip. Final battle! Alright, I'm gonna try and stay as far away from this as I can. But I'm pretty sure it only does that spin attack on like the second half of the battle. But I could be wrong. But we're gonna see here. I just wanna kinda play around with the final boss here a little bit. Just have a good time with them, you know, just rocking out to the final awesome battle music. yeah, he just doesn't seem to really be doing much, is he? I'm just playing around here. Ah, come on, do something, man. Do something, man. Maybe I'll progress the battle a little bit more here. Because, yeah, you know, you gotta do the thing of... You gotta get the camera switched around the back. So you gotta do that thing, and yeah, because the eye... You can't tell if the eye is open unless she's at the other screen, and yeah, you know the dealio. So, okay, let's see if the tornado thing will happen. I should say spin attack will happen. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Hey, you'll be fine. You've been through this before. I mean, it never happened before in the game story ever. maybe I should just cut ahead until he does the attack that I'm looking for. Okay, I did some damage on him. But yeah, basically I'm cutting ahead because I already showed you how to beat this guy before. Now I'm just messing around with stuff, so yes. Yes. Alright. Slow down, lovely. I still need a spin attack going on here, if you don't mind. Spin, spin, spin. I'm far away. Very far away. You should love the spin now, thank you. Oh, here we go, here we go, there we go. I guess I need to do enough damage on him to do that, but yeah, he'll just kind of bounce off the edges of the... Whoa, jeez, I almost took a hit there. He'll just kind of bounce off the edges of the room and... Well, not room, it's like planks that broke off from a ship. It's a shipwreck, but yeah, you get what I'm saying. He hits the edge, he bounces off of it. He sort of kind of tries to home in on you, but the easiest way to dodge is just to hang around the edge and just let him bounce himself away from you. You know, like, let him do the spin attack and then run away while he's doing the spin attack. But yeah, there we go. I can now call this walkthrough 100% complete, and man, am I proud. So with that, I'm ending off the walkthrough here with this one last spin attack, I guess. I hope you enjoyed. Oh! And I will see you in the next walkthrough.